Hello, beta testers. Before I got into Midnight Suns, my biggest worry was the caliber of the writing. And I can proudly claim that my worries were justified.
Worst writing I think I've ever seen.
The writing let down many of the characters in a variety of ways.
The writing is downright terrible.
The writing in this is absolutely nauseating.
Awful abbey where they all live. It's like some kind of fucking YouTuber house.
And yes, it is that bad. I must unfortunately be too black to have ever had anyone turn to me and say, "Everyone tells me I've got the gift of gab."
Want to get your train game on? If not, we can talk a minute. Everyone tells me I've got the gift of gab. How's your mental health? A good portion of this darkness hunting game is mental health and processing intense situations.
Dude.
I'm aware that all some writers see in Marvel are goofy and corny comic book stories, and where we can give boneheaded studios full of woke dweebs like Crystal Dynamics a pass, cause on their best day they might be able to write a She-Hulk episode, people want a Daredevil episode. Jake Solomon, you know that. And marketing knew better. Blade, Wolverine, Ghost Rider, Bathed in Fire, Whip and Chains, Metallica. That's how you sold the game. And the writing is the opposite of that.
There's no darkness and no edge here. It feels like a wasted opportunity.
There is simply too much, and it isn't high enough quality to justify it.
This time at the Abbey should be cut down significantly.
10 hours in, I'm kind of wishing that I didn't have to engage this part of the game.
Something about the tone here does still feel a little off.
At times it takes on the tone of self-insert fanfiction.
The tone the game has arrived at is fairly generic and played out.
And maybe tone is important when you're trying to flex recording 65,000 voice lines for your game. The true miracle of Midnight Suns is that even with how much the writing was a detriment, the gameplay, the deck building, the base upgrading, the hanging out at the Abbey, it made me want more. It tipped the scales in favor of me really liking this game. And even though Blade deserved better, they did get Steve Bloom. They got Nolan North to come back as Deadpool. They got Yuri Lowenthal as Spider-Man. With better writing, this would have just been perfect. But the game's sort of in a fight with itself at times. Did you know? In an interview with Midnight Suns creative director Jake Solomon, he said, quote, "I grew up reading the X-Men, and the X-Men were always hanging out by the pool." End quote. He went on to say, quote, "It made them seem cool. If I looked like Blade, I would be in a swimsuit 90% of the time." End quote. So imagine my surprise after admittedly getting excited to hear about swimsuits, thinking maybe a Marvel studio finally remembered what fun was, to find that you can't use these suits on any character outside of the pool area. Worse still, if the Marvel characters are lounging in this area and you choose to join them, sitting down will teleport them out of the scene, and when you stand back up, they'll teleport right back to where they were. If it seems nitpicky, good, because the Abbey is riddled with these baffling, look what you can almost do type activities, and it'll be my pleasure sharing them with you because it all adds up. Before I continue, I reiterate, I love the bones of this game. The evolution from XCOM of the in-between mission management with a three-dimensional space, I love it. To the whole team, this is good. I respect the size of the Abbey grounds and often wonder how much I'd love exploring Stark Tower or Xavier's Institute for Gifted Youngsters. The Marvel Animal Crossing concept is hilarious. It's goofy, it's comic book, but nailing the characters with good writing is essential. And I'm trying my best not to complain about not being able to bang these Marvel heroes, but again, you know what people wanted. To even have relationship stuff without romance, it's whack. And the Midnight Suns producer himself claimed that the team was leaning into Mass Effect. A game you chose to name drop? Romance everyone, Mass Effect? Miranda Lawson? Mass Effect. You gotta pick a side here. Realness is what made those games the based successes that they were. Blade isn't beloved because he's a candy-ass team player with the gift of gab. Mass Effect isn't beloved because every character is competing for most insufferable. If Wolverine in the upcoming Deadpool 3 movie just made quips like Tony Stark, that movie would suck balls. And that's the tone that this Midnight Suns game strikes. Stark and Strange bickering like a married gay couple back and forth works for a scene or two at most. After that, man, this style seems to be exclusively what new school writers know. And if you take this Saints Row reboot approach of safe, sanitized, androgynous, reduced pickle and melons, no jiggle, no romance, confusion, your project will suffer. Whether it's sexy, cute, or cool, developers, you're the only one in the way of appeal and profit. You take the dinosaur out of Jurassic Park, you try to make the wheels more square, and of course you're going to feel it. Genshin Impact, Fortnite, Dota, League of Legends, Apex Legends, Elden Ring, Hideo Kojima, mobile games, Eastern developers, these entities shame you and show that they represent equality and reality more than any amount of diverse and inclusive signaling could.
I don't get it. Everyone loves surprise birthday parties. I should know. I missed out on a few when I was on the run.
Why are you so concerned?
A birthday party is a good way to lift everyone's spirits. I'm sure we can fix this.
You made me the center of attention I do not need at a party I did not want. I will cut the cake!
Ileana's my friend. How could I have missed this?
You are right to blame yourself. It was selfish of you to spring this on her.
I know. I'm an awful friend. There has to be a way to make this better. I want to fix this, but I can't follow her to Limbo. Although, maybe you could?
This is your mess. You clean it up.
Without magic, we have no way to fight Lilith.
Without magic, we have no way to fight Lilith. Being an insufferable nuisance of a dimwit wasn't enough. Nico needed to be a messmaker, manipulating others into cleaning it up for her. Surely this is worse as a depiction for women than a damn leotard confidently chosen as an outfit by an powerful, athletic woman. If I could fix this whole game, you've played Mass Effect 2, you know what I mean when I say this. I'd make it so towards the end of the game, if you did not establish harmony among everybody on your team, that ending or beating the final encounter would be way more difficult than it would need to be. And what this would force is a bit of tolerance and patience on the part of the insufferable teens. You don't even need to write them differently. You just need to make it so that we should be more focused on the mission than the dynamics of getting along. Whatever stupid thing these little losers want to hear, just play into their bullcrap to get everybody working together. And that would make it so that all of that meant something. I kept hoping for this while playing through the game and almost shat bricks when I thought the game was self-aware.
So, what's our greatest strength?
Lilith has no allies, just thralls. She is alone in this fight, but we are united.
Are we? The greatest scientific mind I've known, sorry Tony, just defected to her side. What's to stop any of us from doing the same? I don't have an answer to the question I asked, but I plan to do what the art of war suggests. Learn her weakness. Adapt as the conflict evolves. Keep Lilith guessing. And above all, think.
But it didn't pay off.
What do you think of Logang? He's alright. You're not jealous? Of course not.
What the fuck, are you out of your damn mind?
Because Midnight Suns is ongoing, I'm eager to see how things change with a coming DLC in the future. I'm interested in whatever comments you may have, or even questions that, as a person maybe that hasn't played the game, you'd like to ask and get my input on. To the sponsors, the patrons, those of you liking and subscribing, I love you, appreciate you. And in the next video, I hope to cover more of what did work for me, and just has me overall liking the experience. But boy oh boy, I do understand objectively, for some people that particularly can barely wrap themselves around the card game aspect of it, to come in and just be gut punched by some of that writing, I don't know, man. So, love you, see you in the next one. I barely started talking about it, and look how long this video is.
He should be able to throw that. It's just a stack of newspapers. Is the implication that it's not going to hurt him? But if he took one of them and rolled it up and gave him a good bop, you know what I mean? I'll stop. That's the kind of writing. That's the kind of writing you're going to get in this game.